Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and the other day Apple released watchOS 7.6 to the public. This is available to all watchOS 7 supported devices, so if you have a Series 3 Apple Watch that's on 7.5, you'll be able to get this update as well. Now along with this, Apple also released iOS 14.7, so you'll need that for this update. You can also use it with iOS 15 betas as well if you haven't installed it yet. And they released tvOS 14.7 and HomePods OS 14.7. For some reason, they have not released iPadOS 14.7 at the time of this video, nor have they released macOS 11.5 just yet. So we're waiting for those to release to the public, but iOS, tvOS, and HomePods OS are now available. Now this update came in at 660 megabytes. That's on my Series 6 Apple Watch and brings some nice changes for different countries and more. Let's take a look at the build number and we'll talk about what's new. So we'll go into our settings here and we'll go back. We'll go to general, then about, and under about, you can see the version number is 18U63. That's the current build. That lets you know that you're on the correct version. Of course, it will say 7.6, but if you were a beta tester, this is the final build. Now, as far as new things in this update, well, the first new thing came along with iOS 14.7, and that has to do with air quality. So if you have the weather app and you go into weather and you scroll down, you'll have air quality in more places now. It's now available in Canada, France, Italy, Netherlands, South Korea, and Spain. It wasn't available in those areas before. So you should see that on your watch as well as your iPhone also. Now there's a couple other changes as well that are significant around the world. This update does not have a ton of changes, but this one is significant since a lot of people have been waiting for it. And if you have a Series 4 or later Apple Watch, ECG support, so where you can use your phone to measure your ECG, as well as irregular heart rhythm notifications, are now available in 30 new countries. So if you're using that feature for your heart, maybe you want to measure ECG, you'll have that option depending on the country you live in. So I thought I'd read through all of the different countries. So hopefully your country, if you don't have it already, is listed here. So the countries they've added support for are Andorra, Anguilla, Antigua and Barbuda, Brunei, Bulgaria, Cook Islands, Cyprus, Dominica, Estonia, Fiji, French Southern Territories, Gibraltar, Guadeloupe, Guernsey, Haiti, Isle of Man, Jersey, Monaco, Montserrat, Nauru, Norfolk Islands, Seychelles, Slovenia, St. Barthélemy, St. Helena, St. Kitts and Nevis, St. Martin, St. Vincent and Grenadines, Ukraine, and Vatican City. All of those have been added for ECG and irregular heart rhythm. And if I said those country names improperly, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And so as far as new updates, it brings that as well as security and overall stability. So there's not a huge amount of changes in this update. And the last time I checked, they did not update their security website. So I'll link that in the description, but let me show you what that looks like. So if you go into Safari on the security updates page, if you scroll down, you can see that it says watchOS 7.6 details available soon. So even though we're a couple days later, Apple has not updated this just yet, but they have released the update with security in it. Why they haven't done that, maybe they're waiting for iPadOS 14.7 and something in that, but generally they will update this site with all of the details. So there are security updates in this watchOS update, but they haven't stated what they are just yet. Now, overall performance does seem to be good. I don't notice any difference between scrolling. Of course, this is the latest Apple Watch, so I haven't noticed any differences as far as that goes. And overall battery life will vary from person to person. This has only been off the charger for a little while, but generally I'll get a day and a half when I'm using this version. So I really don't have any issues. If you're using cellular, working out a lot, and streaming audio, you'll get less time, of course. However, in general, it seems to be okay. And let's go in and take a look at the battery. So we'll go to settings, we'll go back here, and we'll go down to battery. There it is. We'll go to battery, and you'll see we're at 94%, and battery health is 100% on this Apple Watch. So you'll see it was charged 37 minutes ago to 100%. So I have lost 6% in 37 minutes, but I've been using it a lot, messing around with different watch faces and more. so it seems to be okay. And for those of you that always ask, what watch face is this? This is Infograph Modular with the app Lumi added in the middle. So if I press and hold, you'll see it's Infograph Modular. And then I just customized it. If you add the app Lumi, you can add this in the center where it tells you golden hour, the best time to take photos. And you can see it tells you that it's in 7 hours and 42 minutes. Gives the temperature and gives all the different weather conditions. So it's a nice little app, but it is not a free app. So I'll link that in the description if you want to check it out. And other than that, watchOS 7.6 is not a huge update. We get significant updates with watchOS 8, which will be coming usually in September, either with a new Apple Watch or they'll release it alongside iOS 15 when that comes out. So look for that in the future. I also do watchOS 8 videos. So if you want to see what's new in that, I'll link those in the description as well. Now, if you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.